Around the world, GSMA is working with mobile network operators to accelerate SIM-based mobile NFC services and ensure global interoperability. And there is no doubt that NFC is an exciting and powerful technology. Research has shown that by the year 2016, more than $50 billion a year globally is likely to be spent using SIM-based mobile NFC services. So how far has the technology come? Turkcell is Turkey's largest mobile operator with 34 million subscribers. It is at the forefront of bringing mobile NFC services to the marketplace in Europe, being one of the first to introduce a mobile wallet for individual subscribers and one of the world's first commercially available SIM-based Android NFC handsets. The NFC services are just what users are coming to expect. Contactless payment using their mobile phone to pay quickly and conveniently without card or cash. And adoption of NFC goes further. Contactless access is being developed. A food voucher system is being trialed. And NFC will be employed in smart posters where users can hear further information about concerts or even sample music. One of the challenges in all markets up until now has been to increase the number of different handsets available. In Istanbul today, you will find a BlackBerry paying for a can of drink from a vending machine. With the introduction of more than half a dozen more models in the next 12 months, the choice of handset will be wide enough for most tastes. NFC is currently being made attractive to customers here with no charge for subscription to the service or use of the mobile wallet application. The business model charges a monthly fee to banking partners for downloads and apps. The banks gain benefit by a reduction in overheads, lower operational costs, and an opportunity to increase market penetration. Initial customer response to these services has been positive, as users see the benefits of convenient and faster payments. With a loyalty card scheme due to launch within months and NFC use being trialed in public transport, the list of commercial applications for NFC in Turkey continues to grow. What of the rest of the world? In Britain, Barclaycard and Orange have combined to launch QuickTap Mobile Payments, the first mobile contactless service in the UK. Users can now speed up their transactions at well-known chains like Eat, Pret A Manger and Subway, using NFC-enabled phones to tap and go. With a user-friendly payment app, customers can make purchases of up to £15 at over 50,000 stores, with many more services to come. After the success of working together in Nice, Orange, SFR, Bouygues and NRJ Mobile are rolling out NFC nationally, starting with 9 cities over the next 12 months. With over 150,000 NFC handsets already sold, they have 5 different handsets available in the marketplace, and more to come. In Korea, there are already many NFC services across the country. For example, KT uses SIM-based NFC for e-money, loyalty cards, ticketing, transport prepayments, information and mobile marketing. Around the world, you will find operators studying how they will introduce NFC, completing trials, finalizing go-to-market strategies, all on the verge of rolling out commercially. Some will be faster than others, but the bottom line is that, like credit cards in their time, for many, NFC-enabled mobiles are increasingly going to become an indispensable part of everyday life.